Good evening, everyone, and thank you so much for joining us for our first and hopefully only online live open evening. My name is Emily Simpson-Horne and I am head of Dartmouth Academy, and it's my pleasure to be welcoming you here tonight, albeit not quite as we would normally be doing this kind of event. Ordinarily, I would be welcoming you in person in our fantastic Newcomen Hall and giving you the opportunity to see our school site and meet some of the brilliant team that work at the school. Regardless, I'm really glad that you have joined us here tonight, and I hope that this will give you the chance to experience some of what our school has to offer. You might be considering Dartmouth Academy for your child in the primary phase, possibly in our early years unit or the nursery, or you might be considering Dartmouth Academy for your child to join us in the new Year 7 cohort. Hopefully this evening will answer some of the questions that you have and give you an opportunity to see a little bit of what life at Dartmouth Academy is like. So, Dartmouth Academy is a small all-through school, which means that we have education for children ages 3 up to 16 before they leave us for their post-16 studies. We are a part of Education South West, a multi-academy trust in Devon, which means that we get to work in partnership with 10 other schools, both primary and secondary, in the local area. This means that we have a real shared commitment to leading the quality of teaching and learning for every child who is in our care. As I mentioned at the start, my name is Emily Simpson-Horne, and I first started working at the Academy 3 years ago. Prior to that, I lived and worked in Coventry and in Birmingham before moving back down to Devon for my permanent home. From the very beginning, when I first stepped foot inside the Academy, I was really drawn to the magnetism of the positivity that pupils and staff alike who form this community at this school share. It is a school that is deeply committed to supporting all young children to be their best self, both whilst they are embarking on their educational journey with us in school and beyond when they go on to be inspiring young people in their future lives. It is a school which I am immensely proud to lead, and I'm really glad to be welcoming you to hear a little bit more about it tonight. Speaking alongside me tonight will be the other members of the leadership team at Dartmouth, who I will introduce to you in turn. They'll be sharing a little bit about their role in school and the areas of school life which they oversee, and are particularly looking forward to sharing with you. In order for you to know a little bit more about our academy and what underpins our belief and shared commitment here, this is our vision. And our vision is simply that our future successes rest on the work we do today. This statement underpins the design of the school in all areas of academy life, from the curriculum we offer to pupils at every age, to the values which we model and encourage as a school community. We believe that every time we practice, every time we learn something new, every time we are responsible members of our community, caring and looking after each other, it is akin to laying a brick in the foundation which will see each child through for the rest of their life. We believe that every child is entitled to an academic, enriching experience of school, where they are supported to become the very best versions of themselves that they can be. And it is our privilege to support them on that journey. Now, depending on how well you know the school already, you may be familiar with our school motto, and that is to be your best self. It is a motto which is familiar to children at the school at every age, as it is shared daily and used to celebrate the successes that every child has. You will hear pupils using it to describe the characters in the novels that they study in English lessons just as readily as they do when celebrating their success. Be your best self encompasses the core values that we promote and share with children throughout their school life. And these are the values of scholarship, of respect, and of community. At each point in a pupil's journey with us throughout school, these core values are designed to help them build a bright and brilliant future. We know that your child is unique, and we regard it as a real privilege to be able to be a part of their development in becoming their best self and in seeing what they have to offer our school community and beyond. So, At the heart of the curriculum, which has been carefully designed to be academic, rigorous and challenging, supporting all pupils, regardless of their prior attainment, to achieve the best that they can, is the idea of scholarship. Being a scholar is about seeking profound knowledge in a subject. It is the process of learning, always aiming to know that little bit more or to strengthen the knowledge that we have that little bit further, rather than about any kind of innate ability. What we share with children is that it's not about being good or bad at a subject, it's about the process of learning. And we share that the process of learning is supposed to be tricky as we grapple with new concepts and skills, and it is through our continued effort and perseverance that we demonstrate ourselves as scholars. Through our curriculum design, we promote the ideals of curiosity and creativity, teaching our young children that their critical voice and interpretation of the topics we explore in every subject is most important. We want them to know that they have something to add to the study of a subject which has been going on for centuries, and that their voice in it is just part of the next steps for that subject's development. Our curriculum is designed all three. So regardless of the starting point when you join our academy, whether at the younger stage or as part of our new Year 7 cohort, it consistently builds upon pupils' prior knowledge at each stage towards the final end point. And we're really clear at every stage in a child's school career, driven by the potential that every child has that they may one day choose to pursue a subject academically in the future, either through a degree or through training or simply through personal interest. We create our curriculum with this in mind, providing them with every opportunity to make that decision later on in their life. We share the belief that it is each child's core entitlement to learn about their subjects in a way which helps them to be critical thinkers, equipping them with a true depth of knowledge whilst also giving them the tools they need to be able to explore learning to this level. No matter a child's prior attainments, teachers work hard to scaffold their lessons so that all children sitting in front of them in their classroom can be successful in this. And again, it doesn't matter at what point a child joins our school and starts their journey with us, whether from the new Year 7 cohort in particular, because the curriculum is structured so that they can quickly feel confident with what they're learning and how to be successful in it. Part of our Year 7 transition for those who are joining the school is to go through and embed the routines and processes which we become confident with over time, which help your child to embrace their learning and feel really confident with how to study in this way. One of the benefits we also have as being part of an all-through school is the specialist teaching that we can offer children in primary and in secondary. And Jack Pemberton, who oversees primary, will talk about this a little bit later on. But particularly in subjects such as art and design, photography, food technology, French, technology and product design, and science and music, we are really lucky to be able to offer children specialist teaching within that subject. And not only that, we have an incredible purpose-built modern school, which gives children the opportunity to use the facilities and equipment to be really immersed within these specialist subjects. We also believe in offering our pupils not only the core requirements of the national curriculum to an excellent level, but also moving beyond this provision and deepening their understanding. So, for example, at Key Stage 3, an additional subject that we offer is one we call the creative curriculum. And this blends learning about classical and mythological allusions through studying culturally significant music and plays and films. Listening to children at all ages and stages talk confidently about the Greek myth of Persephone and the start of winter, for example, and how that is portrayed in Vivaldi's The Seasons is a brilliant example of that level of scholarly study. And by having this foundation of knowledge, pupils at Dartmouth Academy have an understanding which broadens their study then of other subjects, such as English or music or history. At primary, we're also really clear about extending the offer beyond the classroom so that they can continue to explore and learn and play. For example, children in nursery and Key Stage 1 benefit from forest school, which is woven into their weekly curriculum. Whatever the weather, children are able to go outside and enhance the skills that are then used to support them in their work in the classroom. We also at primary embed the opportunities for children to debate and critically think through the Philosophy for Children programme, designed to support them in recognising the value of their thoughts and appreciating those of the people around them. Another core part of the curriculum offer at Dartmouth, and one we are immensely proud of, is that of the Dartmouth Canon, which is our reading programme that sees us all three. It's another aspect of the entitlement that all children at Dartmouth Academy have, and that is the right to read and explore a broad, diverse and challenging series of texts throughout their time at school in a supportive and safe environment. Mr. Pemberton will talk again about what the canon looks like in primary and how that explores the big ideas that we see in the world around us. In secondary, at Key Stage 3, so years 7, 8 and 9, the afternoon tutorial session is dedicated to sharing guided reading of a rotation of books, one classic novel, one dystopian or science fiction novel, and one modern topical novel per year, in addition to those explored in their English lessons. They read this text together and discuss and debate the big ideas as a class. Literacy and reading truly are the shared responsibility of everyone in school, and it is a real joy to walk around during those afternoon tutorial sessions and witness the shared reading experience and the growing confidence of children as they grapple with these texts. Our commitment to scholarship also extends to all staff at the Academy. We have a relentless drive for excellence in our teaching and learning practice, providing staff with training that reflects the latest developments in educational research and pedagogy. One strand of this is our programme of incremental coaching for every teaching member of staff. We model to children that we can always continue to learn and develop our practice, even when we might be at the top of our game, always honing and responding to the needs of those in front of us. Jane Bloomer will also talk later on about how we use our learning support assistants as vital members of our team and how they are another example of the offer of support for children, all children, to help them feel successful in their learning. So the strength of the curriculum that we offer at the Academy is reflected in the results at GCSE level, especially over the past 3 years. The school continues to achieve above national average progress with a positive upward trend. And this includes pupils every year who achieve the very top grade 9s in their subjects, as well as achieving a personal progress score of 2 or 3+, putting them at 2 or 3 grades higher than their peers nationally who were at the same prior achievement level. We also have a coherent programme throughout school for careers and next steps, and this is something that Nick Perrett will talk to you about shortly. But this results in really successful post-16 choices for all pupils. We've developed strong working relationships as a school with all local post-16 schools and colleges, including Kingsbridge Community College, in order to be well placed to advise and support your child's transition when they have finished their time at the Academy and are looking at what their next steps will be like. In addition to scholarship, then, is the core value of respect. And Dartmouth Academy is a rights-aware school. This is a recognised achievement for schools that engage with the United Convention on the Rights of the Child and the articles which underpin the rights which every child is entitled to. As a school, we share with pupils their rights. For example, Article 29, that education must develop every child's personality, talents and ability to the full. We believe that by knowing our rights and using it to underpin the decisions that are made in school, children are helped to feel empowered and build that critical voice that I've already mentioned is very important to us. It also creates a culture whereby all within the school community understands what it means to respect our own rights, our rights to an education, our rights to feel safe, and the rights of the others, people around us. Article 12, that every child has the right to have a say in all matters affecting them and to have their views taken seriously, is another key component to building a culture of respect within school. Through the tutor system and through our very popular house system with our three houses, Mayflower, Beagle and Britannia, which stretches all through the school, we make space for pupils to share their views on the school and the issues that are surrounding them. And we also provide them with a platform to share with the leadership team their ideas so that we can all continue to drive our school forward, taking on that shared responsibility and a respectful way for presenting our views. And finally, the core value of community. We're really proud of the close-knit community which we have built as a school. I personally believe that the All Through Nature of the school is a uniquely placed opportunity for children of any age. At a younger age, whether in nursery or the primary Key Stage 1 and Key Stage 2 phases, not only is there the benefit of specialist teaching from secondary staff, there is the knowledge that they will grow within the same school, building confidence at every step. And at an older age, especially in Year 7 when our cohort expands, they are joining the school where they have the opportunity to be peer leaders, working with younger pupils to help them on their way. And as Year 7 in particular join for their transition into secondary, it's really helpful to know that they are joining a school that includes primary staff as well as secondary, who understand what it can feel like to go from that one classroom at primary into the multiple different classrooms and teachers for secondary. We also promote as much as possible cross-year group opportunities through, for example, our vertical tutor group system at Year 7, 8 and 9, where the tutor groups are mixed and they join together in the morning and the afternoon, again providing them with the opportunity to build relationships in different year groups. Our clubs also run to encompass many opportunities for children in every age group to join. Part of our community as well is knowing that success for children requires helping them to feel safe and secure, and also recognising that they may face personal challenges during their time at the school. We have a dedicated pastoral team made up of our student achievement managers, our Inspire School leader, and other members of the team too, who are there to help any child with their emotional well-being and any issues that they might face. We also have a school counsellor available for when further support might be needed. As a school, every member of staff also recognises that children's wellbeing is often linked to how successful they feel in school and with their learning. And for this reason, we have a programme of academic tutoring in Year 7 to 9 for any child who needs some additional mentoring, helping them to set and reach goals to help them feel good about their learning and make progress moving forwards. In Year 11, which is a particularly crucial time in their school career, pupils also have the option of a member of staff becoming their specific mentor who looks out for them and helps them with their organisation and their self-study in the build-up to GCSEs. And of course, a vital part of our school community is the relationship that we can build with you as the parents, and we want to provide as many opportunities as possible for you also to share your views and to get to know the staff who are working with your child when they join the school. At primary and at secondary, the class teacher or the tutor is an important person to get to know as the first port of call for any questions or queries regarding your child in school. Particularly in Year 7, when they first join the school, we have a very early meet the tutor evening at the beginning of the term, which is a good opportunity to meet the tutor for the first time and to go through any questions that you might have regarding the transition and iron out any concerns that your child might have raised so far. We also have regular parents' evenings in primary and secondary, either meeting the class teacher regularly in primary to see your child's work and the progress that they're making, or at secondary to meet with every subject teacher for your child and to set targets moving forward and reflect on the success that they have had with their scholarly learning. Oh, and my light has just gone out. Well, that's the difference perhaps in doing this remotely rather than being able to do this in the hall. That seems like a good opportunity to introduce the other members of the team who are going to be talking to you tonight. So I'd like to introduce, first of all, Jane Bloomer, who is our assistant principal and our SendCo, who's going to tell you a little bit about her area of school life. Thank you, Jane.
Thank you, Emily. As Emily mentioned, we're really proud of the support that we put in place for all our learners. And right from day one, when your son or daughter joins our school, we'll be doing our very best to get to know them, regardless of age or ability, regardless of what stage they join us. We plan our lessons using quality classroom teaching for the graduated response to respond to different needs, and we put pre-teaching in place to build confidence with new topics. It might be that there's something different coming up in science, or somebody hasn't studied that topic in RE or geography before. By going through the language and the concepts beforehand with them, we build confidence in learning and we build classroom practice where children can be successful. There may be small group work to support social and interpersonal skills, and we recognise the importance of people's mental health and well-being, with additional literacy and numeracy delivered through timetable support using programmes such as Read, Write, Ink or Sparks. We know our pupils well and we continue to make reasonable adjustments or look for alternative strategies to help every child thrive. Any pupil may be assessed for additional support in exams, whether SATs or GCSEs, and this bespoke approach informs all levels of our work. With the right support in place for a range of needs, we foster strong relationships between home and school, consequently seeing children flourish under our care. We look forward to getting to know you and welcoming your son or daughter to Dartmouth Academy to work with all of us, whether we're teachers, whether we're support staff. At the Academy, we all care about your child. I'll now pass you on to Bex Dark, Associate Principal for Behaviour and Attitudes, as well as our designated safeguarding lead.
Good evening. As previously mentioned, we consistently reinforce that Dartmouth Academy pupils be their best selves. And we strongly believe that positive reinforcement of these correct behaviour choices will ensure these are maintained and are consistent. Live behaviour for learning grades, praise points, outstanding behaviour for learning stickers are all examples of how pupils are positively reinforced and are continually rewarded for making those positive behaviour choices. Catch them doing something good is a mantra that is instilled within staff at Dartmouth Academy, ensuring that the positives will always outweigh any negatives. The pay slip is a tangible reward which pupils receive every week, highlighting all of their merits, their BFRL average, their attendance, but also if there have been any demerits, so pupils can clearly identify where it's been slightly tricky and what they're going to do in order to make that better next week. Pupils are motivated and driven to increase the points on their pay slip each week, and they're always continually working to achieve their bronze, silver, gold and even platinum blazer badges, which are on reward. The house system, which has previously been mentioned, is an all-through intervention where pupils from EYF, all the way through to year 11 collect house points in order to be awarded termly and annual house rewards. Pupils develop team cohesion, identity and leadership as they individually cooperate to their house's success, a true sense of unity, passion and determination. An essential element to my role is attendance. Similarly to the points I have already discussed, attendance at Dartmouth is positively reinforced with house points, attendance merits, and specifically 100% attendance is rewarded with entry into our termly Kindle raffle. We strongly believe you've got to be in it to win it. It now gives me great pleasure to hand over to Nick Perrott, who is an Associate Principal responsible for personal development.
Good evening, everybody. Part of my role is the responsibility for all things linked to progression, particularly at year 11, for their post 16 choices and involving careers and community links. A fundamental part of careers is raising aspiration early on. To this end, we work with our primary pupils and Key Stage 3 about where their interests lie. This is in order to facilitate appropriate and suitable GCSE choices and then later on appropriate post 16 choices. All staff are responsible for careers and the guidance that comes with that, which is why every curriculum area includes careers within their teaching. Another part of my responsibility is community links. They're many and varied, and you will have seen us out and about in the community, and indeed many of you will have been in visiting us yourselves. We invest in our wider community as much as they invest in us. I'll now hand you over to our Associate Principal for EYFS up to Year 8, Mr. Pemberton. Thank you.
Mr. Pemberton, I think it's possible you might be on mute.
Thank you, Ms. Horn. I was just testing everybody else was awake. Thank you. Thank you, Nick. So where better to start than at the very beginning of your child's journey in our early years foundation stage? So we have a purpose-built, spacious learning environment. Designed by our early years specialists and opened in 2013, our learning environment really is the envy of other schools. We have experienced and dedicated staff. So our lead teachers are experienced early years experts and specialists in delivering the very first steps in learning to read. We've joined up provision from day one. So as part of our cathedral building approach, we have the highest expectations and ambitions of our youngest for our youngest learners. We have shared nursery and reception resources. So our nursery and reception classes share in their learning, supporting, leading and learning from each other. And as mentioned by Ms. Simpson-Horn earlier, whatever the weather, our youngest pupils will be outside with their Forest Schools trained teacher every week. And talk a little bit about reading and how much we value reading in the primary phase at Dartmouth Academy. So we believe that reading is the bedrock on which our cathedral is built. Our stage not age grouping for the daily teaching of phonics ensures that all pupils leave Key Stage 1 with a secure understanding of phonics and a growing fluency. In Key Stage 2, our pupils use Accelerated Reader to track their progress against their chronological age. Teachers provide daily focused reading sessions to guide learners towards books that they love and books which inspire a lifelong love of reading. And through the primary canon, we aim to guide children through modern and classic fiction from a diverse group of writers to promote cultural awareness and empathy. But sometimes we'll just want to share a fantastic adventure or a wonderful book of poems. And as Ms. Simpson-Horn has mentioned, we have a rigorous knowledge-based approach to our humanities and science curriculums, which are designed to ensure our primary pupils are absolutely secondary ready by the time they leave the primary phase. And that subject specialist teaching and resources, and thanks to the way that we structure our all through timetable, primary pupils are taught by specialist teachers in specialist learning environments. And as a primary school, we're in an incredibly fortunate position where we have access to these resources. And the all important enhanced transition to secondary. So by the time our pupils reach the end of year six, they already know the teachers and the classrooms that they'll experience in their secondary school. And I look forward to discussing any questions you may have about our wonderful primary phase at Dartmouth Academy. First of all, I'm going to hand you back to Ms. Simpson-Horn for some closing words. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Pemberton. So that's a good place to start phasing towards the final part of our virtual open evening. In a moment, I will share with you a video with some clips of some of the aspects of school life that your child will experience when they join us. I'd like to thank you again, though, for visiting this evening. And although we can't do it in person in the way that we might have done otherwise, if you have any questions or if you would like to learn a little bit more about some of the things that we have touched upon tonight, please do be in touch with the school at admin@dartmouthacademy.org.uk to organise a call or a Teams meeting with one of the leadership team so that we can help you with your child's move to our school. I really hope to be able to meet you in the future. And for now, please enjoy this final video with some elements of our school life. Thank you very much.
Best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest. You can beat the world, you can win the war. You can talk to God, go banging on his door. You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock. You you can move a mountain, you can break rocks. Some will call it practice, some will call it luck. But either way, you're going through the history books. Standing in the Hall of Fame. And the world's gonna know your name. Cause you fell with the first flame. And the world's gonna know your name. And you'll be on the walls of the Hall of Fame. You can go the distance, you can run the mile. You can walk straight through hell with a smile. Be a hero, you can get the gold. Making all the records they thought would never be broke. Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride. Never gonna know, never even try. Do it for your country, do it for your name. Cause there's gonna be a day when you're standing in the Hall of Fame. And the world's gonna know your name. Cause you're fine with the be students, be teachers, be politicians, be preachers, yeah. Be believers, be leaders, be astronauts, be champions, be truth seekers. Be students, be teachers, be politicians, be preachers, yeah. Be believers, be leaders, be astronauts, be champions. Standing in the Hall of Fame. And the world's gonna know your name. Cause you fell with the first flame. And the world's gonna know your name. The King and Kong banging on your chest. You can beat the world, you can win the war. You can talk to God, come banging on the door. You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks. Some will call it practice, some will call it luck. You can be the way you fall to the YouTube. The King Kong banging on your chest. You can beat the world, you can win the war. You can talk to God, go banging on his door. You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock. You can move a